Okay, then let us have our Dhamma sermon. We are in Dhammapada, stanza number 144. Asso yatha badro khasa nivitto atata pino sangvegino bhavat saddhaya sile nacha viriye nacha samadina dhamma විනිච්චයන ච සම්පන්න විද්‍යා චරණා ප්‍රතිස්සතා පහස්සත දුක්ඛ මිදං අනත්තකම් Last evening we start to discuss about shame and fear. How important in our practice to develop our shame and fear for unwholesome thoughts. Now, this stanza also continuation of that previous stanza. Asso yata badro kasa nivittu. High caste family horse done a mistake. Because of that mistake, he get a punishment, whip punishment. So, after that punishment, that horse no need to get any other more punishment because he is very pride. So because of that prideness, that horse demanding valuable, excellent horse try to continue his speed and his journey, happiness of his owner, because he was in shame because he got punishment from his owner when he done some mistake. Asso yata badro kasa nivittu. Same as using, taking that as a simile, atapino sangvegino bhavat. Atapino sangvegino bhavat. We have some kind of obligation. We have responsibility, duties. What is that duty? Atapino. To tame our defilements, to control, reduce, and eliminate our defilements. This is our duty. This is our responsibility. So, sangvegino. Therefore, disappointed about your unwholesome thoughts, unwholesome behavior, disappointed of your unwholesomeness. Being a disappointed person and develop your energy to tame, to control, to reduce, to eliminate your unwholesome thoughts from your mind. Sangvegino bhavata, be that kind of person. Being that kind of person, these are the qualities that you should develop. What are those? Saddhaya, develop your confidence. Saddhaya, the word normally, generally we use faith for Shraddha. But I like to use the word confidence because Shraddha, as you know, this word faith, when we use the word faith, it is kind of religiousistic word. But as I mentioned before, Buddhism is not just a religion. It is a way of life. It is serving as a practical application for our life to apply. Therefore, we can't do nothing with faith. Faith driving into wrong direction. Faith is kind of blind path. So, better to have confidence. That confidence means you have faith, but you are connecting with your wisdom. Wiseful faith you have. This is the explanation. Shraddha, the word Pali word, Shraddha, we can translate into wise faith, not blind faith, which is very equal to confidence. You have faith for Buddha because you have confidence of the Buddha. Yes, he did investigation, research, re-research, and then he realized the truth. You have that confidence. This is the Shraddha. And you have confidence of the teachings of the Buddha. This is right. This is the way that we should live to attain enlightenment. This method is the only one and only method to that attain enlightenment. You have that confidence. This is the Shraddha that Buddha mentioned in here. So Shraddha, you should have the quality of Shraddha. Wise faith or confidence. Silena cha viriyena cha. And also you should tame your word and action, which we call sila. Sila means virtue, morale. But basically what's happening there, you are taming your word and actions. You have so many words can speak. You can speak so many words. But when you are taming means you are not ready to use any of unwholesome thoughts, unbeneficial thoughts for you and others. Likewise, lie, harsh word, and useless word. Those are the words that we consider as unbeneficial word. To whom? Everybody, you and others, me and others. Silena, it means when you are developing your virtue, you are taming your word, not to use any of these unbeneficial word. Why? If you are using any of unbeneficial word, which is cause for your unhappiness, and also it will direct affect your concentration. Tame in our word and action, we are trying to develop our concentration. Tame in word and action is very helpful to develop our concentration. Then what is the actions? Basically, you observe not to kill, not to steal, not to adultery. These are the basic things. So when you are in this stage, in this platform, you are taming your word and actions. Your word and actions. Then as a result of that tame, that virtue, you can develop you can gain your concentration, which is very helpful for our practice. So sila, sila energy, viri energy, and also energy. Effort, as you know, in Noble Eightfold Path, there are four kind of energy effort that we should develop. First thing, just think about wholesomeness and seeing that wholesomeness, then you ready to develop your energy effort to develop your wholesomeness, to develop your wholesomeness. And seeing unwholesomeness, you develop your energy, control your unwholesomeness. What kind of skill that you have, you are trying to develop that skill using your effort. What kind of unskillfulness with you, you are painful attention to get rid of that unskillfulness from you. This is the way how you should use your virya, energy or effort. Each and every Dhamma practitioner, they should have this quality to achieve their goal, to accomplish their wishes. They should have this quality. Samadhina, then practicing all these, we can develop our concentration. Samadhina. Samadhi is very important. That is, samadhi is one of goals that we are trying to achieve. Natti janang apanyas panya natti ajayato. Yamhi jananche panyache savenibhana santike. There is no concentration without wisdom. No wisdom without concentration. One who has wisdom and concentration is close to peace and emancipation. This is one of very important stage in our path, in our practice. So we are pay full attention to gain our wisdom. Gaining wisdom is one of goal. We practice meditation, we do such a meritorious deed, having that goal to develop our concentration, gain our concentration. Without concentration, there is no wisdom. No wisdom. Wisdom is the things that we should develop for our realization, attain enlightenment. So, to gain wisdom, we should develop our concentration. This is the connection with concentration and wisdom. So, practicing, developing all these, we should gain our concentration. And also, Dhamma Vinichyena, and also we should do investigation. Dear friends, Buddhist practitioner should be an investigator. According to the Buddha's explanation, you know, in one of quality that Dhamma has, Ehi Passika, come and see. Come and see means inviting you to do investigation. If you are not investigate, then you are depending on your faith, your blind faith, your beliefs are the important. But practicing Buddhism, we are going against our beliefs. Beliefs are not important. What is the important thing? Pachattang veditabbo, realization is the important. To realize the truth. What is the realization? The truth, the reality, what it is. This is the realization. So to realize the things, realize the reality, we should do investigation. Without investigation, without making argument, questions, and research, you don't have any path to realize the truth. So now keep your mind, we are practicing Dhamma for what? For realization. Therefore, first invitation, first of the one of quality that Dhamma has, come and see. For what? Pachatang with our realization. For our realization. Therefore, we should do Dhamma investigation, not investigation, some other things. Not the investigations of mundane things, unnecessary things. Investigate yourself. What does it mean? Investigation, your practice. Investigation of your goal. Investigations of the reality. This is the very important thing. Sampanna Vijjachana, then you can accomplish Vijjacharana Sampanna. Vijjacharana means there are few things which we call Asta Vidya Pasalos Charana. There are 8 kind of knowledge and 15 kind of practice. Asta Vidya Pasalos Charana. What are the 8 kind of knowledge? Vidarsana Jnana. You have knowledge of insight. And Manomaya Jnana, Manomaya Iddhi Jnana. You have some power to read others' mind. Iddhi Vidya, Divya Shrota, Parachitta Vijanana, Pubbe Nivasanusrati, Divya Chakku, Asavakkaya. All these are the knowledge that you're going to develop through this practice. Asta Vidya. And Pasalus Charana Dharanam. I don't have enough time to explain all these things, but I just mentioned him. You can do investigation about these meanings. What is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of that? You can investigate. Pasalus Charanam. What are those? Pratimokka Sangara Sila, about discipline, virtue. Indriya Sangara Sila, Bhojana Mattanya. And Jagaruntaya, Shraddha, Hiri, Ottappa, Bhavasrutta, Virya, Smuti, Panya, Akasanyayatana, Akinchanyayatana, Vinyananyayatana, Nevasanyayatana. These are the Pali words. You can see the translations and the explanation. These are the things, these are the qualities that you can achieve to your practice. Sampanna Vijjacharana. So, Sampanna Vijjacharana means these are kind of achievement that we can gain through our practice. Practicing Dhamma, these are the gains that you can do. And Patissata, next one, Patissata, establishing your mindfulness. Your mindfulness is establishing. When you establish your mindfulness, you are not losing your mindfulness. You can see what is happening, what you are doing, whether it is according to Dhamma or not, you can see through your mindfulness. Patissata. And also, in here, all these qualities we are developing for what? To practice Dhamma, keep our mind on right path, without losing any opportunity. Because already we got punishment. The Buddha used a simile in here. The horse who was very proud, he got punishment because of his mistake. We also got punishment in sansaric journey. What are the punishment that we got? Jatipi dukkha, jarapi dukkha, vyadipi dukkha, varanampi, appayo, sampayogu, piyo, vipayo. Birth is a punishment for us. Why? Because of this birth, we are subject to decay. We are subject to die. We are subject to die. No one can avoid. So, all the punishments are here with us. Now, what we should do, seeing this punishment, taking as a punishment all these results, we should develop these qualities. What are the qualities? Sraddha, Sila, Virya, Samadhi, Dhamma Vinicca, Sampanna, Patissata, Vijjacharana, Sampanna, and Patissata. These are the qualities that we should develop. For what? Not to continue this punishment and to end this punishment. To end this punishment. Otherwise, if you are not able to practice, develop these qualities, then you might get punishment again and again. Again and again. No one can avoid, no one can escape that punishment, because those punishments are depending on your action, your practice. Therefore, we should be very mindful person. Being a mindful person, we have to develop our shame and fear not to continue this sansaric journey, not to be in this birth and death circle, sansaric circle. If you are a fearful person, if you are same, in same, then you have courage not to continue this sansara. Dear friends, this is very simple things that we can understand. Likewise, think about yourself. Somehow you had eaten some kind of food which is not healthy, which is not supportive for your health. You had eaten. As a result of that, you got some sick. Sicknesses is there. We can get an example through the sugar. We like to eat sugar. We like to have sugar each and every time. But because of that sugar eating habits, we got diabetic. Then, being a diabetic person, now if you are willing to continue that habit again and again, it means you don't have shame and fear. For what? For your unhappy situation. The sicknesses are not kind of happy things for you. Being a diabetic person, you can't be happy. I have diabetic. It is not something to happy. To say something to happy. Therefore, what you should do, take that opportunity as an opportunity to be a same, be in same and fear. Then you ready to control your sugar, eating sugar and using sugar, you are controlling all the time. Therefore, wherever you're going, if someone offering something to drink or eat, you're ready to check the sugar level there. Investigation is there. Mindfulness is there. But sometimes, perhaps seeing all these things, okay, that's enough for today. It is better to have only piece of cake or piece of things just only for today. Why? You are losing your virya. Your effort is losing. You don't have effort. But you should investigate and also you should develop your virya. This is the way how we should practice Dhamma to control our word and action, develop our wholesomeness, reduce our unwholesomeness. Seeing our weaknesses. Oh, anger is arising in my mind. You can see anger is arising. Anger is not healthy. It is unhealthy things. I am burning myself. So seeing that things, investigating your anger, I'm not supposed to continue my anger. I should reduce, I should get rid of my anger from my mind. You're ready to develop your energy. You're ready to develop your effort. Seeing lust in your mind, you're ready to reduce, you're ready to control your lust. Oh, this is not something good. It's burning myself. I don't want to continue it. Then you're ready to add something for that. Seeing anger, seeing lust, seeing desire, seeing greed, all these things, you're ready to develop your energy to control this, to reduce, to eliminate. Who can do that? Who are investigation Dhamma? They are the people who can do. What kind of qualities they should have? Sila, Samadhi, Panya. All these qualities. In here we mentioned about Sila, Virya, Samadhi, Dhamma, Vichaya, Sampanna, Vijjacharana. All these things under these three things. Sila, Samadhi, Panya. So these are the qualities that we should develop. Seeing the reality, then we can get rid of our pain and suffering, unhappy things from our mind. This is the way how we can practice Dhamma. This is the way how we can practice Dhamma. Practicing Dhamma means you are applying these qualities, you are developing your qualities for what? To achieve eternal happiness, you can achieve it, entering Nibbana. Eternal happiness is in Nibbana, eternal happiness. So we are working for our own happiness. Your Nibbana is not helpful to someone else. You can't share your Nibbana, but you can share your experience and knowledge with others. But Nibbana or enlightenment, realization, no one can share with any others. So we have to work for our own liberation. We have to work for our own liberation. Now you can see in here, in this stanza, we have to be sinful for what? Being in this samsara. Why? All these sufferings are here in this samsara, in this life. We are not able to establish our happiness. Happiness is losing all the time. Sometimes we are happy, sometimes we are unhappy. It's changing all the time. No one can stop that. Why? Because of this is the nature of the samsara, mundane life. So seeing this truth, reality, we are developing our effort using this opportunity. We born to this human world as a human beings. That is kind of proud things in this world, in this universe. Being human beings is not easy thing. So, developing your sinfulness, we should use that opportunity, having fear with us, to practice Dhamma, to see the reality, to gain our concentration and wisdom. So, use this opportunity as a helpful things to develop your insight. Develop your insight. So now you can see what are the goals, what are the qualities that we should develop. Buddha in this instance are giving us a wonderful simile. The simile is proud horse who got punishment, keeping that things in his mind, he is ready to get rid of his laziness. Painful attention and gaining energy in top of level, he ready to perform, same as us, to perform this Dhamma practice. We should develop these qualities, being a sinful person. Why? Even though being born in human world as a human being, why we want to waste our time and energy without using benefits for ourselves, for our own liberation? This is the cause, this is the reasons to develop our same. So let us practice Dhamma, seeing this reality and truth for our own liberation. I think that would be enough for today. Thank you very much for your participation. And let us use this opportunity to share merits with others. First of all, think about our departed relatives, friends, family members, and pets who departed name of us, who are suffering in this samsara, death and birth circle. By the power of these merits, may they be able to get rid of their suffering. May they have peaceful, happy life. May they be able to attain Nibbana, having that aspiration, share merits with that departed one, saying, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Whoever is affected COVID-19 and any other sicknesses, who are suffering with these sicknesses, by the power of these merits and metta thoughts, may they be well, happy, and peaceful. May they be able to get rid of their pain and suffering. Having that aspiration, make blessings upon them, saying, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. May you all be well, happy, and peaceful. All your wishes come true by the power of these merits and metta thoughts. May we all be able to attain ultimate bliss of Nibbana, having that aspiration, say, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. By means of these meritorious deeds, may I never join with the police. May I join always with the wise until the time attain Nibbana. May the suffering be free from suffering. May the fear struck be free from fear. May the grieving be free from grief. So too may all beings be. From the highest realms of existence to the lowest, may all beings arisen in these realms, with form and without form, with perception and without perception, be released from all suffering and attain to perfect peace. Excellent, excellent, excellent.
Thank you, Bhante. Thank you, Prime.
Sadhu. Sadhu, 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 sadhu.